Hi, thanks for joining us here on the web at WMUR.com. I'm meteorologist Josh Judge. A couple of flurries rolling through tonight. Otherwise, it's the cold we're talking about for the next day or so, and then the potential for some snow around here, maybe a lot in some locations. But very bitter cold air is sinking into the state and sticking around for the rest of the week. It's going to be a cold week ahead. And that cold teams up with this piece of energy and this moisture from the Gulf of Mexico. They come together and head toward us to bring us a snowstorm for Thursday. However, with all the cold overhead, that may act to displace the storm a little bit farther south. And so it's a bitter battle here of the bitter cold and the storm trying to make its way up into New Hampshire to see which winds out. It looks like we get some snow out of it, but it'll be farther south than it could have been. If it came farther north, we would be seeing even more. That means that southern New England will probably see the highest snowfall totals out of this storm. There's a look at some of the snow showers or flurries that could roll through during the nighttime hours tonight for New Year's Eve. And then as we head into Wednesday, we look for a mix of clouds and sunshine, more clouds in northern New Hampshire, but a cold day, as you would expect, similar to what today was. There's a look at the snow beginning to work its way in for Thursday. It moves in during the early morning hours of Thursday, anytime after midnight or 1 or 2 a.m., depending on where you are in southern New Hampshire, and then spreads its way northward through the morning hours. So most of us, it will be lightly snowing when we wake up Thursday morning. However, the first half of this storm is sort of lighter and on-off, so not a whole lot of it accumulating the first part of Thursday until we get into the afternoon and evening hours, and then the snow comes down heavier. So it's a long-duration event, meaning some hours we don't get any snow, some hours during Thursday only a quarter or a half inch, other hours could pick up an inch or so here and there. It all pulls away early Friday morning between 7 and 10 a.m. is what we think right now. And so that means that it'll be coming to an end during the morning commute of Friday. Bitter cold for both Thursday and Friday, and enough wind. This is a very light, fluffy snow. It'll certainly be a lot of blowing and drifting we'll be contending with of the new fallen snow. And very bitter cold temperatures, as I mentioned. The wind chill will make it feel below zero much of Thursday and Friday, and the actual temperatures only in the single digits to teens at best. Now, with that cold air, we introduce in that what we always call the fluff factor. It takes less moisture, less water in the clouds to make more snow. So that's why we're saying 6 to 12 somewhere in there, maybe highly variable in these locations. Hopefully all these areas will be somewhere between 6 and 12, noticeably less as you head north of the notches. For tonight, cold and more cold for your New Year's Eve, with temperatures bottoming out below zero in the North Country, some areas even colder than what you're seeing there, single digits elsewhere. But look at the bitter cold that's on its way in for later this week. Thursday and Friday will be the coldest. Finally, on Saturday, we start to see some slightly milder air moving in. Sunday, we're well into the 30s. That brings in mild air for Sunday and Monday. And believe it or not, that might mean by Monday there could be some rain around here. We'll have to watch that very closely. That's your forecast. Happy New Year, and thanks for joining us here at WMUR.com.